In the previous video, I talked about the pods. What is a pod? Why it has been created? Why not run two applications in one container, but rather run it in one pod as two different containers? We talked about why and what of pod. Now we're going to talk about when you might want to create more than one container in a pod. What are the use cases and what are the design patterns? And this is the documentation from Kubernetes official page, and I have just saved it as my Evernote notebook. And this talks about patterns or design patterns when you want to co-locate more than one containers in a pod. Now, what is definitely an anti-pattern is, let's say you have an application that we are looking at here, and this application has multiple services. There's one for front-end, then there's a catalog, which is another back-end service, then there is another service for carts. Now, running these containers, which are like this one application with Golang and then another with Node, and running these applications together in one pod is definitely strictly a no-no. And why is that? Is because you may want to scale just the front end. You may want to just scale catalog or cards. And each of this is a microservice. If you start packaging it together, then you start defeating the purpose of and the advantages of using microservices. Your unit of scaling when you deploy it as different pods becomes just one application. Whereas if you club it together, the unit of scale becomes front end and catalog, and then cards if you club all of these together. If I want to just scale one of this, it is not possible to do that with individual, or clubbing it together in one pod. And that is when, for most of the patterns, you're going to run one application in one container in one pod. That's what you deploy. But there are situations when you may want to run more than one containers, and that's what we are talking about here. This first design pattern is called as sidecar containers. Now, sidecar has become more generic word, and even if you look at, let's say, ambassador and adapter, most of those are also called as sidecar container. The concept of sidecar container is basically you have one main application, and let's say this is a Node.js application serving the web pages, and then there's another auxiliary application. Sidecar container is typically an auxiliary application which independently has no use, but it works in tandem and supports this application and provides some service to this application. Basically, in this case, there is a Git synchronizer which collects or updates the files. Again, we looked at the pod in the previous video where we talked about two containers in the same pod can share the same mount path. That is really advantageous here because this is responsible for updating the files, whereas one application is dedicatedly serving it. So we have just split it into two functionalities. And the second question, very important one, is when do you decide to run two containers in one pod? Is you decide, or you ask this question, can I run these two services on two different nodes? In this case, it is of no use, because then, how would you manage the files? How would you share it? You want this application to run along with your main application. Whereas if you decide to use, let's say, our application stack here, you can run this on one node, this another node, and they are connected over the URLs or domains or, ports or something like that. And that can easily work fine. And if you can answer that question, let's say, can I run it on two different nodes? And the answer to that is yes, run it in two different pods. Simple as that. If the answer is no, you might want to consider using one pod. Now, this is the auxiliary application and a sidecar. The second design pattern is called as ambassador containers. Now, in this case, there is a PHP application here. This is an example of it. And then the PHP application connects with the Redis shards. There are more than one shard, so there is, and each of that shard may have a separate set of database. If the application wants to connect to it, it just contacts, instead of keeping track of each of the shards and adding that configuration, it connects with the Redis proxy over the localhost, because they share the same network, both containers in the same pod. And this connects to the Redis proxy. Redis proxy is in turn responsible for maintaining the list of shards and keeping track of it and updating it as needed. So this simplifies the work for the main PHP application. All it has to do is connect to this, Redis proxy, and Redis proxy in turn is serving as an ambassador for the Redis cluster here. That's why this is called as an ambassador container or ambassador service. The third is an adapter container. So it adapts to certain thing and sends it across to external service. In this example, the application is Redis, generates the logs, and those logs are extracted, and there are specific fields which are then taken out as per the requirement, and those are sent to the external monitoring system. Could be Splunk, ELK, or some other monitoring system right here, and that's what happens here. So this generates the files, and those files are then processed by an adapter, which converts it into the format that is needed by the monitoring system. Again, as I mentioned, both of these, ambassador and adapter, also can be called as sidecar containers typically. That's the generic name for the auxiliary applications. Now again, these are the design patterns, and you might have to look at your architecture and then decide when to run two containers in one pod. This is another example that I use as part of my course, which is, one is the Nginx application, which is serving the web pages. Then there's another application called as fsync, which runs the git sync and updates the files and stores it in the shared mount here. This is the main application. This is the auxiliary application. There's another example. Now it's becoming really popular. There's a service called as Istio. Istio maintains and allows you to create a service mesh where one service is connected to another. It discovers it. It maintains load balancing, routing, and a lot of other things. And for doing all of this, it runs a proxy in every pod. So this is again an auxiliary service which maintains a contact with this service, collects the data that is needed by Istio itself, and then sends it to the Istio's control plane. And in turn, that control plane makes intelligent decisions on routing, load balancing, and a lot of other things. It gets the monitoring data as well. And for making that happen, you need, it's like an agent running on every node. And in this case, that agent, that proxy, is collecting the data and running along with the main service. And that is why this is an auxiliary service. And this runs in the same pod. So in order for setting up Istio, one of the important steps is to basically add this container to the existing pod, that existing pod or existing service that you're running. So I just give you a couple of examples of when do you run multi-container pods, and three design patterns: sidecar containers, ambassador, and adapter.